Hello, my dear students, a very hearty welcome to my channel. In today's video, we are going to revise some SQL questions. So we are going to see some SQL problems and we are going to solve the SQL problems and see how they can be worked upon. So I'm moving on. So we will be doing SQL revision. So let me first bring in the very first question. So we have the very first question over here. Consider the following table named soft drink and write commands of SQL for 1 to 4. So the table is given to you and you have to write the SQL commands. So the first is, you can see the table fields: drink code, D name, that is the drink name, price and calories. To display names and drink codes of those drinks that have more than 120 calories. So for this, you can say to display name and drink code. So we have to display name, D name and drink code for all those drinks where calories are more than 120. So what are we going to do for that? Let us see it over here. So we will write the query as select D name comma drink code from soft drink where calories are more than 120. So greater than 120. So this is the query for the first one. Next is to display drink codes, names and calories of all drinks in descending order of calories. Now for the previous one, what should be the output? We'll discuss the output also. So we will get the first one. It will check, it will select this one. And question is more than 120 calories. So this is 120. So this one will be rejected, this one will be rejected, and this will also be rejected, and this one will be accepted, this one will also be rejected, and this one will also be accepted. So the answer is going to be this, that is, we will be writing first D name. So the D name is going to be green mango and 104. And next one is mango juice bahar and 106. So this is going to be the result of the first query, that is this one. Now let us see the second one. To display drink codes, names and calories of all drinks in descending order of calories. So we will be using the order by clause over here. So it will be select. Now because my SQL is not case sensitive, hence we can type the names of the fields in any case which we want. So drink code, I'm just typing drink code like this, D name and calorie from soft drink where. We don't need a where clause because we only need to display everything, all the records in the descending order of calories. So order by calories, DESC. So it will display all of them in the descending order. That is, over here you can see the very first one is going to be, I will remove these process. Okay. So now over here, what you are going to get is the first one will be, because we are displaying everything in the descending order. So the first one will be 150. Next one is going to be 140, then 135, then 4. Okay. So this one would be taken in the same order. That is, the first one will be taken first. and the next one will be taken next, and 5. So this will be 5 and this will be 6. So this is the order in which all these values will be displayed. Next is to display names and price of drinks that have price in the range 12 to 18. So both 12 and 18 included. So we have to display names and price of drinks. So we will write for this. Select dname, price from soft drink where price, so I'm going to type where here, where price between 12 and 18. Alternatively, you can also write where price is greater than equal to 12 and price is less than equal to 18. So this also you can write. Next is increase the price of all drinks in the given table by 10%. So increase means it is an update query. So we are going to run the update query for this. So update soft drink, that is name of the table, set, now we have to set price equals price plus price multiplied by 0.1. So, and that has to be done for all the records. Hence, that is the reason why no criteria has been mentioned. So, we are going to just write the statement. So, wherever it finds, so for all the records, it is going to give a 10% increase to price. Okay, so price equals price plus price multiplied by 0.1 will give me the answer. Let us move on to the next question. Now this question says, table club has 4 rows and 3 columns. So we have a table club which has 4 rows. So let me first draw the table. Because it has 4 rows, so it would be somewhat like this. And 3 columns. So table, so it will be 1, 2, 3, 4 rows and 1, 2, 3, 3 columns. Table member has 2 rows and 5 columns. So we have another table member. It has 2 rows and 5 columns. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1 and 2, and this table is member. What will be the cardinality of the Cartesian product of them? So if we do the Cartesian product for club and member, that means every tuple of club will be matched with every other tuple of member. So that means its cardinality is going to be number of rows of club multiplied by number of rows of member. That is equal to, here it is 4 and here it is what? 2. So 4 twos are 8. This will be the cardinality. And what will be the degree of it? Degree will of course be degree of club plus degree of member. So that would be 3 plus 5, that is equal to 8. So here in this case, both cardinality and degree are the same number. Let's move on to our third question. So this is the third question. So again an SQL over here. So I will bring the text object. So consider the following table named gym with details about fitness items being sold in the store. So write a command of SQL for 1 to 4. So you can see this is a table named gym, and within this you have I code, I name, price and brand name. And the first one says to display the names of all the items whose name starts with A. So again a pattern matching, and you already know we can use the like keyword for doing that. And here also we have two things. One is an underscore character which represents any one character, and there is a percentage character which represents zero or more characters. Zero or more occurrences of the same character. So let us just type it. So select, we have to display only names. So I name from gym, where I name like. So in like we are going to provide, it starts with A, and rest it could be anything. So it will be A and percentage. So it will only give me these values. Aquafit, that's it. Okay, Aquafit hand grip. This is the only value which I am going to get. Right. So this will give me the value, that is Aquafit hand grip. All those names starting with A. Next is to display I codes and I names of all items whose brand name is Reliable or Costco. So display I codes and I names of all items whose brand name is Reliable or Costco. So let's do this. So it will be select I code, comma I name from gym, where brand name is, so you can write it in many ways. Either you can write equals to Reliable, or brand name equals to Costco. So you can write it in this way also, or you can write it alternatively using this brand name in Reliable or Costco. So this is how you can write the second one. Let's come to the third one. To change the brand name to fit trend India of the item whose I code is G101. So let's do this. Select, sorry, it is again an update query. So update brand name, sorry, I have to write the name of the table first. Update gym set brand name equals fit trend India, where I code is G101. So this is going to, now this output statement, you can update statement is for one particular row, that is for that item whose I code is G101. So we have to provide a where clause over here. The last one, add a new row. So add a new row means it is an insert query. So insert query will be written in this way. Insert, it's written add a new row for new item in gym. So insert into gym. Now because values for all the fields are given, so we don't need to specify the field names. Enter into gym values. The first one is a string value. Second one is also a string value. Next one is a numeric value. And the last one is also a string value. So this is the insert query for this table. So you can see how it is. So this is how we are going to solve this question. Let's go to the fourth question now. Our fourth question is, Mr. James created a table client with 2 rows and 4 columns. So client is a table with 2 rows and 4 columns. That is 1, 2, 3. Okay, I'll be doing it properly. So 2 rows and 4 columns. So 1, 2, 3, 4. He added 2 more rows to it. That means over here 2 more rows are added to it. So they will also have 4 columns. And deleted 1 column. So that means, let me say this column is deleted. This particular column is deleted. What is the cardinality now of the table client? So cardinality is, as you can see, 2 more rows were added, hence cardinality will be 4 and degree will be 3 because 1 column has been deleted from this. We'll go to the next question now. That is the fifth question. So again, that same question. So we are going to see this. It is a table fitness instead of gym. And here, first one says to display the names of all products with price more than 20,000. So let's do it. So we will see select names of all products. So we are using pname, and let us provide price also because we need to check those items with price greater than 20,000. From fitness, where price is greater than 20,000. So this is done. Next is to display the names of all the products by the manufacturer A1. Manufacturer A1. So we are going to write this also. Select pname, comma, or we can simply write pname from fitness where manufacturer is equal to A1. Next, so here for A1 there is only one product name, bike, and that will be displayed. Next, again to change, that is, it is again an update query. So to change the price data of all the products by applying 25% discount reduction. So now we have to provide a 25% discount reduction. So how will we do this? So update fitness set. Now we have to change the price of all products, right? So price equals price minus 25% of that. So 0.25. So price minus 25% of price. Where, sorry, we don't need where because it is for all the products. Then to add a new row, so this is again an insert query. So we will write the insert query in this way. Insert into fitness values. Now again we will be entering all the values. Why? Because we don't need any specific field here. So this is the insert query for this. Let's move on to the sixth question now. So here it is write SQL commands for the following on the basis of the given table. That is club. To show all information about the swimming coaches in the club, that is easy. Select asterisk from club. So this one we can do. Second one, to list names of all coaches with their date of appointment in descending order. So we have to display the names of all coaches with date of appointment being displayed in the descending order. So select coach name, comma, date of appointment. So date of appointment spelling has to be taken care of, from club, order by, date of appointment, DEST. So this is the second question. And the last one, to display a report showing coach name, pay, age and bonus, 15% of pay for all the coaches. So here we will be using an expression. So how to do that? Select coach name, comma, age, comma, bonus. So we will first calculate 15% of pay. So for this, firstly, this pay field is going to be used. So pay, we have, it is what, 15% of pay. So that means 0.15. And this is an expression and it has to be displayed as bonus. So we can write it as bonus. Okay. So we will write it this way. Pay multiplied by 0.15 as bonus, name this as bonus, from club for all the coaches. So you can see it over here. So this part is an expression and this is an alias name which we have used for this expression. In today's class we saw 6 SQL questions. In the other classes also I am going to take up many such questions of different types, so that you have a complete idea about what type of questions you will get in your exams. So that's all in today's class. We will meet again in the next class. Thank you, everyone.